Hey y'all, my name is Bailey Versick and I'm here with my colleague Meryl Fernando, and today we're going to talk about Windows Slope for Business, specifically Cloud Kerberos Trust, which you may hear us refer to as Cloud Trust. And so today we're going to kick things off with explaining how provisioning works and then later go into how authentication works and how you would deploy this in your own environment. So first of all, I want to say that you should I highly recommend that you use Kerberos Cloud Trust unless you have a very compelling reason to use a different deployment model. So we'll focus on that for today. And so when we look under the hood as to how Cloud Kerberos Trust provisioning works, after we target our users with root policies and then the user device registration checks all pass, first, when we look into provisioning, the user would enter their credentials, which we can assume for this purpose is a username and password. Then when we start provisioning, the provisioning app will pop up, and under the hood, the app will request an access token from the device registration service. Then the user will hit next and they're prompted for MFA. And when that's successful, the device registration service will issue an access token. And the device registration process is going to monitor MFA throughout this process to ensure that the user always has a valid MFA claim and nothing is revoked during the process. And assuming the user has a capable device that is Windows Slope for Business enabled, they will be prompted to enroll in biometrics. So the user also has the option to hit skip if they don't want to use biometrics. Now, the part that they can't skip that is necessary is when the user needs to create a PIN. Creating the PIN is absolutely mandatory as it's part of the failback or in case of failback. So this is industry standard. You likely see it today on your mobile phone. If you unlock your phone with a biometric, it'll fail back to a PIN if the lens is smudged or if you're in direct sunlight. This can also be very useful if the Windows Slope for Business enabled device is docked with the laptop folded downward at your workstation and you still want to log in. Now, once that process is complete, provisioning will request a Windows Slope for Business key pair from the pool and ends the registration service access token to the device registration service for user key registration. Now, the device registration service will locate the user in Microsoft Entra ID, and it will write the key info to an attribute on the user, which will include a reference to the device, so the user and the device are tied together. Then it signals it's successful by returning a key ID to the provisioning app on the client, and we're done. Now, when we talk through authentication and how Cloud Kerberos Trust authentication works, if you compare this process to KeyTrust, for example, you'll really see a big difference. And what's cool here is that we've abstracted away the authentication from on-prem ID to Microsoft Entra ID. So first, when the user goes to sign in to Windows with their new credential, we'll do some quick validation to ensure that Cloud Trust policies are still in place and enabled. Then the cloud authentication provider calls out to Microsoft Entra ID to request a nonce, which is then returned to the client. And the client is going to sign that nonce with its private key and return it to Microsoft Entra ID. Microsoft Entra ID does some validation to make sure there's a Kerberos server key matching the users to the on-prem domain. And then it's going to create a partial TGT and a PRT. And it returns it to the client, and it's cached by LSAS, like other authentication, as long as caching is enabled. And it's not until the very last step where we go on-prem. So this is where we'll use the DC locator service to contact a 2016 or later DC to exchange that partial TGT for a full TGT, which is then cached, and then we're done and the user is authenticated. Now, I just showed the flow for if the device is Microsoft Entra hybrid joined, but if you're a Microsoft Entra joined device, you won't go through the process to get the TGT until the user actually tries to access an on-prem resource. So about at that orange line is when that process is going to stop. Now I'm going to hand it off to Meryl to talk through some of the prerequisites and to go into a demo.
Cool, awesome. Thanks a lot, Bailey. So let's first look at what you need before you can deploy Windows Hello for Business with Cloud Trust. The first thing you need is to run a supported client version. So Cloud Trust is supported on Windows 10 and later, and you need a minimum of 21H2 for Cloud Trust to work. Next, Entra ID needs to know about these users and devices. So the users and devices need to be synced, and the devices need to be intra-joined or intra-hybrid joined. You also need to have an adequate number of domain controllers in each site running at least Windows Server 2016. The Windows update we released here was when we first introduced Kerberos back in like 2020. Then configuring Entra Kerberos is probably the biggest new thing, and it needs to be configured for each domain that has your users and devices. Also, to enable Windows Hello for Business Cloud Trust, there are policies that need to be deployed to your devices through Intune or another device management solution. Finally, in order to onboard with a strong credential, we need the user to actually perform the multi-factor authentication the first time Windows Hello for Business is enabled on the device. Next, let's look at what you need to do to set up Cloud Kerberos Trust. The first prerequisite is to set up Entra Kerberos, and it's quite straightforward. All you need to do is download and run a PowerShell script as the domain admin. Now, it needs to be run against each of the domains in your environment that contains the users or devices where you want to be able to leverage Windows Hello for Business. What this does behind the scenes is it creates a Kerb TGT user and a read-only domain controller compute object in Active Directory for each domain that's not tied to a physical server. So as part of this, we sync the RODC secret, that is the read-only domain controller secret, back to Entra ID, which forms the trust between Active Directory and Entra ID. This is just so Entra ID can generate those ticket granting tickets or TGTs for the Active Directory domain. Active Directory will then trust and exchange those partial TGTs for the full Kerberos TGT. Next, let's look at the second step. Right, so now that you've done all the prerequisites, this is the actual part of configuring Windows Hello for Business. There are two policies that need to be configured. One is for the configuration of Windows Hello for Business, like how long you want your PIN to be and other details. The other policy is to enable Cloud Kerberos Trust. And that's it. As you can see, this process looks simple because that's exactly how we intend it to be. Once the users have these policies, they'll be prompted to provision with Windows Hello for Business once the client prerequisite checks pass. Perfect. Now that we've seen the prerequisites and how to configure and deploy Hello for Business Cloud Trust, in the next video, we'll give you a demo of how you can set this up. We'll give you a troubleshooting guidance and how you can communicate with your end users and deploy them. So make sure you follow us on the second part of this video, which gives you a hands-on demo of how Windows Hello for Business is set up. Thanks a lot.